then we will see what is meant by total quality management. Before going to actual session of TQ, we will see famous Qualiy model of quality. This is the Qualiy model of quality. Here, the graph shows basic needs, then these are performance needs, and these are excitement needs. In basic needs, we know, suppose for a human being, food, clothing, and shelter are the basic needs. Why? For other things, for any product, the needs are different. Suppose it is a two-wheeler or four-wheeler, then basic needs are it should run, it should transport the person from one place to another place. Then performance needs are related with the functions, mileage or pickup. So these are the performance needs. And excitement needs, within the same price, how much features that same product is giving. The best example is smartphone. In 10 or 15,000 rupees, you get the maximum features of the smartphone. A number of products like computer, telephone, message service, all these products are combined together. So that is the best example of giving many features in the same price, that is excitement needs. Customer wants this excitement needs. If basic needs are satisfied, it's okay. If performance needs are satisfied, he is happy. But he is delighted if the excitement needs are satisfied. These are the critical dimensions of quality: performance, features, reliability, performance, durability, serviceability, aesthetics, and pursuit quality. So these are all expected by the customer from any product. Now we will see only few of these features. For any product, features require different. It depends on product to product. Then reliability. It is the ability of the product to perform satisfactorily throughout the life under given environmental conditions. Conformance, whatever manufacturer has specified in the manual, these features should be observed in the performance. Then durability, it should have a longer life. Serviceability, it should be easily serviceable. Aesthetics, it has got very much importance nowadays. And pursuit quality, so whatever is there in the minds of the customer, as per its expectations, product should meet the performance. This is the journey of TQM or Six Sigma. It started from 1975. It is given up to say 1995 or 2000 and beyond that. So in 1975, there was producer was the king. Means there was monopoly in the market, very less producers, and whatever they were going to sell, it was sold in the market. The price was decided by the producer. Then, as years went on, the production quantity in 1980, they started producing in more quantity, that is mass production. In 1985, there was a birth of quality circles. Then inspection process started in about 1990. Here is customer is the key. That is, it was buyer's market rather than seller's market here. So here employee involvement was there, and then employee empowerment. So nowadays these are the basic quality tools used. That is total quality, Kaizen, critical to quality, customer voice, 7 QC tools, customer satisfaction in this. Now this is a story of three men. Three men, they were breaking the stones. Each man was asked one question: what you are doing? First person told, I am breaking the stones. Second person, he told, I need to work for living thing. For living. Means for living I have to earn my bread and butter, and for that I am using this. And the last person told, I am breaking stones which will create monument. I am breaking stones which will create big monument. Means see the difference between the approaches of three persons. Same task done by the three persons. One is just telling that I am breaking source. He is not emotional. He is not attached emotionally with the task he is doing. Second person is, he is saying he is somewhat better, but he is also saying that I am doing for earning my bread and butter. Third person, he is having positive attitude. He is saying that he is doing that task which will create the world class monument. Means what has to be done, that idea is clear in his mind. So these are the persons needed in the society. This is integrated TQM model. That is, TQM stands for Total Quality Management. This is world class organization, and different elements are there, like people. Here it is given total employee environment, leadership, teamwork, and consensus. As you know, leadership is most in any organization. So, very much emphasis is given on leadership in this total quality environment. When total quality control, there are different tools like system, SPC, statistical process control, PDCA, that is plan, do, check, act, doing cycle, problem solving tools. Then appropriate technology, the technology which is suited for that organization, like just in time or waste elimination techniques. And the most important is, here it is continuous improvement, that is Kaizen. Means one should not stop by doing breakthrough improvement once. Small improvement, but it should be on continuous basis. The common perception, it is often uneconomical to make quality improvement since it brings down productivity and increases cost and investment. It is shown with the help of this equation. Suppose there is a perception that thought is there in the mind of the people that if you want to improve the quality, productivity will decrease and cost will increase. But what is the reality? In reality, you can see the equation. Even if quality is improved, productivity also improves it and cost comes down. So that is the famous Deming's sentence, productivity goes up and cost comes down as quality goes up. This practice well known, but only to a selected few. Now, this is one of the famous movie, Indian movie, Chak De India. It is about the hockey team. The team members are all scattered initially, and all the girls, they are quarreling, they are not having any positive approach. But when they get a good coach, the scenario will change and how they win the match. So the movie is based on that theme. 16 girls, different types, different backgrounds, different skills, sets, but one dream, that is winning. All functions must work together towards an objective, creation of success through a die-hard attitude, teamwork, high energy, and extreme passion for work among the team. Extreme passion, this is important. Everybody is doing some work, but one should have passion towards the work. A leader who made them realize their own potential. This is again the leader of the team. And he says, jo nahi ho sakta hai, wahi to karna hai. These the things which are difficult to do, that things are to be done, and that is possible only with a good teamwork. It is very important to possess right attitude. A positive body language can make a huge difference. Team, the letters in the team can have a long form like this. T is for together, E for everyone, A for achievers, and M for more. Together everyone achieves more. That is about team. Success does not mean the absence of failure. It is about winning the war and not every battle. This is very important. It doesn't mean that you should not fail at any step. You can fail. The persons who try, who do some work, they only fail. So failure is not a crime, but don't try is a crime. So it's about winning the war and not every battle. Battles is a small task. So if you lose some task, if you fail in some task, it doesn't matter. But ultimate is, aim is you should win the war. That is important. Like the story of Kabir Khan and his six singles, all organizations and its employees should work towards a common vision and be a part of a team that believes in creating a world-class organization.